the last 3 years. This is a marriage between Bluebird, which is the body company that I represent, and Roush, which is the fuel design system made by Jack Roush, the same NASCAR guy, has created this fuel system that's revolutionized fleets, but especially school buses, and also has a Ford. Our marriage with Ford is also evident too, with a Ford V10 engine. So while it's more advanced than what today's diesels, it became apparent that a few years ago diesels were overly complicated, and so this revolution or change in thought was something that Jack Roush studied and worked with Bluebird to create propane power, which really was already out here, but at the time it wasn't liquefied injected. Now it's liquefied injected, and what that means to you is it's very much like your car. So when a driver starts it, it's quiet like a car. It's 50% quieter than a diesel, and it's amazing. Most drivers enjoy it. It has power like a car. There's a little training differential there that you have to work with, but it's turned out to be, well, we have 6,000 of them now on the road around the country, and Pennsylvania is the fourth largest state in the country that has propane-powered buses. Primarily also is because propane comes from Washington County, Pennsylvania. So it's a terrific American story, and thanks for letting us show it to you. I'll just show you the engine first if we're out here. This is called the Bluebird Vision, and it was named the Vision because of the hood, so that the driver could see in the danger area here. But what's really neat is for years, the diesels kept getting more and more complicated and stacked up, and Bert knows this, they became more and more contraptions that we had to involve to meet all the EPA guidelines and standards. Well, propane really was approved in 1993 to be already met EPA standards, so it was really an easy fit. The biggest difference was the system that the company that Derek represents, Roush, designed an injection system that made it, again, like a car. So some of the problems in the old days with vapor-driven systems, which was the old technology, had trouble in winters. Now we have buses in the Yukon, Minnesota, all over the America, and even in the northern climates where it starts up very simply. You don't plug them in at night like you do diesels. It's an energy saver too in that respect. But this is just the gas V10 engine. It's smaller than the big diesels. Today the diesels just encumber the whole underside of the hood because they've got all these EPA things that go along with it. But it's a V10 engine. There's 1.3 million on the road already, this same engine. And again, I told you there's 6,000 of them in a school bus. So it's really changing our whole business. So